Bridesmaids and groomsmen, you have earned your spots due to one thing and one thing only, loyalty. We are gathered here today to witness the beautiful union of two amazing souls, Jacob Wetzel and Sydney Arendt. Their story can be written not by a romance or passion author, but a fantasy one, because most readers would not believe their adventure to be true. Sydney, a pretty, selfless, and passionate human being who sacrifices most of her day to the care and comfort of complete strangers. And Jacob, against all odds, and I'm not saying that lightly at all, persevered to where he is today, and one of the small number of Wetzels to achieve his master's degree. You both found each other not by looking for each other, which is one of the truest forms of love, and how I discovered my own beautiful wife. Pure chance, sure, but fate finds a way. Your love shows that two different worlds can collide, and love is the end result. Great Falls and Big Timber. Wow.
Smiling, we're all smiling.
He's crying.
Yay! Such a noob, Danny. You're such an awkward hugger. Good job, Danny.
I get sad at weddings.
Oh, wow.
Just give it to me.
Here. Oh, wow, you're gorgeous. All right, now give me that. Glad it's not raining right now.
Knock on wood.
Yeah. Oh my God. You look beautiful. How you feeling?
Thank you. Good. You look good too.
I'm wearing my J's.
I know.
I thought you would like that, but you gotta do it anyways. I'm not wearing this, right?
Yeah, you can wear it that way.
How am I not gonna be stepping on that later?
We'll figure it out. You look awesome.
Well, here we are. Here we are. I haven't eaten anything all day except for a granola bar. I've been so nervous. Oh my God, here we go, Sid. Here we go. You ready?
When I first laid eyes on you, I couldn't have imagined the impact you'd have on my life. Little did I know, the firecracker, blue-eyed, blonde girl would be the most important individual and aspect of my life. Since our first time hanging out from hunting clowns in the middle of the night in Great Falls, you have showed me love, loyalty, and affection. Through my most catastrophic, proud, and life-changing moments in my life, you have shown me the true meaning of love and what a ride or die is. You accept me for my flaws and push me to be great every day. Sydney Elizabeth, from here until the end of time, I vow to make you smile each and every day. I vow to pick you up when you're down and share your load. I vow to protect you and our family. And I vow to grow with you. And I vow to provide love with all of my heart until the end of time. I was shaking writing these because I'm so excited to make you my forever and always. I love you, Sydney, and you're here to forever.
Jake, I remember one of the first times I saw you. Little did I know, I was looking at my future husband and father of my children. You have shown me an incredible amount of love and tough love when I need it. You have supported me and encouraged me with every journey I take. And it's a good thing opposites attract, because I can't make a basket and you can't play defense. So our kid should be the ultimate basketball player. You see the positive in everyone and every unimaginable situation. You've been dealt some really tough cards in life and had to handle a lot of those tough times on your own. I vow to always be there, so you'll never have to deal with anything alone again. People like you don't exist anymore, Jake. Your soul is pure, kind, loving, and caring. I love you more than sparkles and spaghetti. And I can't wait to start this journey of life as one together.
Oh, that was awesome. Good job.
I'm like sniffling.
First, you gotta bring up my defense. Oh, you gotta bring
Sydney, your smile today is only outdone by the smile of Jacob when he sees you. Your care and love for him, a trait I thought was dying in our society, teaches old buggers like me that selflessness is not dead. Jacob, my boy, the trail you had to take would break most people. You were placed in unforgiving circumstances where you bear no fault of your own for being there. You could have used a hand from someone like me, your uncle, but life finds a way to distract us. I'm sorry, my boy, but look at you. Look at where you are now. Look at what you have achieved, and most importantly, look at her. You've been through so much, but now is the time that you look into her eyes and say, I will be there for you, Sydney. You need her, but she'll also need you, Jacob. Both your grandfathers smile upon you today. And our beloved Scott, your father, is also here with us in spirit. You're not alone. Thank you, Ken, Scott, and Crystal, and Mike. You both need each other. Boyfriend and girlfriend is no more. Life is hard enough. So be the best husband and wife you could possibly be. I'd like to thank Dick Buckus Jr. here as the ring bearer. Love this kid. Has he given you the rings, Christian? Yeah. Bring forth the rings, Chris. Thanks. At the end of what I'm about to say, say I will. Will you introduce me as that hot uncle of Jake's with a personality like no other and never mention that I made it to state in speech and drama?
I will.
Jake, my boy, will you honor, love, and cherish your wife, Sydney, in sickness and in health, through the good times and bad, and be that shoulder for her to cry on, and love her and no other, now and forever, till death do you part?
I will.
When we golf, give me the largest allowable handicap. I'm going to break some clubs, my boy. Ladies and gentlemen, gives me great pleasure to announce to you, Jacob and Sydney Wetzel. Sydney, welcome to the Hot Blondes for Wives Club. Kiss her, my boy.
Woo! said I would never fall unless it's you.
It's official.
I fall into. I was lost within the darkness, but then I found her. I found you.
You know, this guy, where he's been, where he's at, and where he stands today, he's just an amazing woman in his life. Sid, welcome to the family.
You guys have that unique kind of love that makes forever seem like it's doable and real, and it can be achieved. I'm blessed to be a part of your day. I'm more blessed to be a part of your guys' lives.
There are a lot of stories I could share about Sydney, like how she had to ask for one of those estate. How she was ambitious enough to believe she could be a baby doctor, a professional snowboarder, and the Seahawks mascot all at one time. Sydney, I'm incredibly proud of you for everything you've accomplished, and I'm so happy that you're my sister.
Thank you. You've made such an impact on my life. We've been through everything together, your journey for everyone. Just the career paths you guys have chosen, you're going to make such a difference to so many people. And that I can be here and be a part of it, I love you guys.
Said I would never fall unless it's you I fall into. I was lost within the darkness, but then I found her. I found you.
So congratulations on your marriage. And Sid, you remember, it was probably about a year ago last week. What did I tell you at our wedding? What did I tell you? I said, you're next. And it kind of happened that way, right? So you can listen to me from now on.
You've taught me a lot of life lessons along the way. I think my favorite one is not to take a laser pointer to a high school football game and pointed at the band about 5 minutes in. He's got the whole side of the stadium chanting laser pointer at him. His phone dies, and I meet up with him after the game, and he's talking to cops.
Sisters have been great, but having a brother now is awesome. But he still can't guard me in basketball any day of the week.